would you, yeah, what would you like? Third section.
I'm following you guys.
That's good.
It's 2 days.
We made it all the way through his man punch.
Yes, we did. We're just run the whole third section, just kind of preview. I believe we're gonna stick with it, and then come through it all the way.
Or at least the next couple of moves after his man punch.
Well, the rest of our, there's almost 90% repeats after that. So.
Oh, okay. Well, that's right.
So let's do the whole second, let's do the whole third section. After, basically, from fans, or like, you know, once you get to Krusty, Push, Neil, and Siva in that section, you basically repeat a whole chunk of the second section. Just repeat it all the way up through High Horse. And then some new stuff happens. To the very end. So you've got most of it already. All right. Transition to climax. got the bird's tail. Turn body cross one kick. Brush knee push. Actually, no, that's brush knee punch knee groin. I always want to do brush knee push times two. Brush knee push, brush knee punch knee groin, and grasp the bird's tail. Bow to shoot tiger. Hip and hand punch. Withdraw and push. Cross hands. Feet together. Yeah.
I get it.
There's a few, like, don't know anything about those moves.
And just a couple. Just a couple.
Moves I know, but I may not know where they go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm feeling that.
Good job. All right, we have 12 minutes left. Is there a move you want to look at or a bit you want to run through? Anybody?
Have I horse?
Have I horse for people? Okay. So, watch it a couple times, so just like second section from single whip, cat high horse. For piercing palm, these are just kind of my little personal edits. There's a sink. I sink and step, shift, and so it's not, to me, it doesn't feel quite the same as I sink down, step in, step out, double dragon, split place. But there's a little bit of like a sink and slide out. And again, don't Google this. This is just my interpretation of this, or how it feels to me. So, half high horse. I'm going to sink, block down, step, shift, and some people, again, that's fine. Some people will really do a straight thing. It's somewhere in here. You're either going to raise eyes, jab, you know, something, somewhere. This surface
chin move.
Hmm?
It was the chin move.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
I remember that. Where it goes.
Where
chin? Yeah.
It's a little bit of that in shoulder throw.
Is the bottom hand up or down?
Block, so it's down.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. You want to try it together?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, so from single whip.
Yes, ma'am.
Everybody remember how to do cat high horse?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so step forward, half plank, set the foot down, shift. Then you're going to basically switch your hands. You're going to lock down with the left, pull it to your waist, go to a cat stand, and yep, everyone's there. All right, so I'm going to sink a little more, and I'm going to block. Like, don't hit me. I just don't even try to throw a punch. I'm going to block, step out with my heel. Now I'm going to shift, and come forward with my piercing palm.
So left-handed, that once you drop it a little bit to the block, it really doesn't move.
Correct.
Okay.
That's correct.
Hey, it should be.
This one. This one is a tiny bit narrower than.
Oh, good. That was narrower.
Yeah, that's correct. That's why this isn't exactly double dragon's foot placement. And the reason is you're trying to set it up to turn with the foot placement for the kick that comes afterwards. So for me, and again, this is going to vary from body to body, but you know how they say that if you get problems with a move in Tai Chi, check two moves back? You know, this is definitely one of those setups. So where I'm headed with this is I'm trying to get to here so that I have room to sit back and get ready to lift this knee for a kick. I don't want to be here, and I don't want to be here. That's going to mess me up. So the foot placement for piercing palm is just a tiny bit different than it would be, because if I were just basic double dragons, first of all, this is weird, and then I end up here. If I don't step a little bit longer, you know, if I just do here, I'm squished. So it's a tiny bit longer, a tiny bit narrower, so that when we get to turn body and cross form kick, you've got a good transition and starting point to get to it. Yes. So that's why I describe this from Pat High Horse. I'm going to sink and step, and then naturally, if I think that sink, it naturally kind of puts my foot in the right place, and it lets it go, that sinking lets it go out a little farther to shift to here. So that when I turn, I mean, I don't want to do this all day, but I'm sitting on one leg, you know, here, so that I'm able to lift this knee for that kick, yeah, which we haven't gotten to yet.
That doesn't feel too bad.
No, it shouldn't. I mean, like, when it's lined up correctly, I mean, yeah, you feel it, but it's not terrible, and you feel like you've got room for your hips, you've got room to sit back, you feel balanced versus tripped up. Or totally cross-legged. Yeah.
And when you do that pivot, are you doing it on the heel?
Yes. Okay. Yeah, I'm turning the toes pretty far in. Yep.
That's not bad.
Except if you start there, you want to turn all the way around.
Okay.
So, which means, you know, this is kind of turning into a cross-form kick lecture, which we'll pick up next week. But, see, obviously, it goes this way to this way, but I'm doing towards the camera. I'm here, just like Fair Lady with shuttles, how far my foot comes in. So that when I sit back, my hips can open this way.
Oh, you go all the way around.
You go all the way around.
And I'm feeling a little dangling stretch in there, too.
Yeah, for sure.
And that last one.
So we'll look at the positioning to step into that kick on Tuesday.
Okay.
But yeah, just like Fair Lady with shuttles, that foot comes all the way in so that you can sit back. Yes.
Not full.
No.
I get tired.
Yes, Mr. Linda, that's the right idea.
But I lost at the end. I think my head went out of the line.
That's it, Mr. Linda. Yeah. Yep.
Okay.
All right. Stuff to think about? Synapses exploding?
No, but one more thing. Make it happen.
The second pivot. You pivot on the left foot, then the right. Are you doing the heel or the toe?
Well, so since I'm just going to be setting up for the kick, I sit back and just lift the heel and keep the foot where it is.
Okay, gotcha.
Yeah.
Oh.
So again, so if I'm here, off this foot.
Okay.
So then I'm ready to do the classic kick outside inside. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Great. Thank you.
We'll work on it. All right. Any questions before we bow out?
Come in.
Bow to advanced and intermediate level students at home. Master's Five Training is